These are the one of the sweet pea stamps that I just got. This is how it comes. It just comes, it's a piece of rubber. And what you want to do is get a sheet of mounting, and this is easy mount. And then you also need a pair of scissors. I like to use these. They're short, and that makes them kind of easier to use with the bigger handles. So what you want to do to start is you're just going to peel this off and keep your fingers off it because it's pretty sticky. And then you just start sticking your stamps on. Just make sure that all of the part that's going to stamp is on there. I usually just go ahead and stick everything down and fill it up. If I was planning on just putting down one or two stamps, then usually I'll maybe cut the sheet in half or just cut it down a little bit and leave this the sticker part on it. So sometimes I almost fill it up and then I think, okay, let's take a piece like this, I'll just go ahead and put that part back down on. So this is very simple. The only things they would probably suggest to you is to kind of watch the angle of your scissors when you are cutting. What you don't want to do is come in and cut your image and cut it so that you undercut into the stamp. That's not good because if you undercut in the stamp, it makes it so that this doesn't stamp very clearly. So you need to make sure that your scissors are at least straight up and down or angled out this other way so that the big end is on the outside, just so that you make sure that you don't ruin your stamp. So usually when I do it, I'll just come along and cut. I found that it's easier to cut when the rubber is stuck onto the sticky part. It's not a very good idea to pre-trim the rubber, even though that sounds like it might be easier. It's really not, just because so much residue builds up on your scissors that it's not a good thing. So when you have your stamp started there, what I usually do is I keep it in kind of square angles to start with. I'll just kind of cut down until I have, you know, a pretty good square. Some of them are actually square, quite a few of them are. And then I'll go through and I'll just start notching out, if you can see the shape here. I chose one specifically that had more shapes on it so that I could show you what I do with that. So see how I just pulled that out. You want to take off that excess just because your ink is going to end up pulling there. Like if I left this like this, you can guarantee pretty much that I'd have ink here and probably some ink here. And it kind of messes up your image, so it's not very clear. So it's a good idea, in my opinion, to do that. As long as you don't cut in too close to the rubber, you want to get close, you know, but not so close that you end up cutting into your shape or whatever. So I mostly try to use more straight lines. Sometimes when you start getting into too much curving, it ends up undercutting into your stamp, and you really don't want that. After you've invested in your stamp, you don't want to ruin it by how you choose to cut it out. So I would just, it's really simple though. Anybody can do this. It's not really rocket science or anything, but I know a lot of people, I've heard mention that they have felt kind of intimidated to do it at first just because they're not used to it, and or some people don't know you're supposed to cut them out, and then they want to leave their stamps just how they came, and that doesn't work out very well because it doesn't stamp the best. So see how I'm just kind of nipping off all the extra. Actually, myself, when I stamp it, I would probably even take this corner out right here because there's no stamp in there. But I don't know, I'll probably just leave it for this, but. So there would be technically my finished stamp. And then it's so easy, you just would peel off this little backing back here on the opposite side. Looks like that. And then you just have an acrylic block and it'll just stick right on and you are ready to stamp. And then when you go to store them, you can just, I actually store mine on these. They are just these storage sheets here. And what I do with mine is I just stamp, you know, stamp what the images are and then stick them facing on the opposite directions. So there are my stamps, and then I like to write down, you know, what they are, and then there they are on the opposite side. So thanks for watching. Hope that was helpful.